a child, I used to cuddle and enjoy it. When I grew up, it helped me in building my ideas. As I started my schooling, that thing helped me in mapping things easily. When I was in a situation to frame my career, that thing guided me, gave me a spark, and helped me frame my career. Last but not the least, that is the thing which is triggering me each and every second to keep me abreast with the latest technological developments. We all believe, right? Playing is our best test busters. In my point of view, I consider them as my mentor. Friends and parents, while you keep guessing, let me introduce myself. Greetings to none all present here. This is Srinivas Raghavan, a 9th grader from Karen Public School, India, here to talk about that mentor. Yes, toys. How many of you here like playing with toys? I know everybody would be crazy about toys, right? I'm a toy maniac since childhood. Even now, if my mom takes me to a shopping mall, my eyes would search for a toy shop. Basically, we all would have grown up along with it. That is why we feel that toys are our first siblings. As we are growing along with it, it has unleashed many of my rather our creativities when we explore them. I have overcome many things through thick and thin as I have spent more time with my toys. Like how small droplets of water make a mighty ocean, small things bring in big change. Why can't small things like a toy bring a mighty change in us? Toy World will surely help us to scale up our skills. When I was having discussion with my family members, out of curiosity, I asked my dad what toys he had. He was just saying, when pigs play, his dad gets him a toy. But he said his favorite toy, Tops. I know, most of you would have played with Tops, right? When my dad was sharing his childhood photos, he was true. He didn't even have a single toy. Rather, he was sitting like a toy without any smile. But now, my dad gives me a chance to explore the whole toy shop and gets me a toy without any hesitation. Of course, he has no other go, he can't escape. Anyway, toys of today are filled with technology and have attractive features that makes us crazy to learn new things and explore the hidden treasure. When I asked the same question to my mom, she said she could count the number of toys she had. She said toys like Tops, cartoon character dolls, Rubik's Cube, shells, marble balls, water guns, kitchen set, squeezing toys, stones, yo-yo, maze games, and even tamarind seeds. Most of the parents over here would have definitely played with stones, tamarind seeds and shells, right? I have heard that most of the traditional games have come back again during the lockdown period as we all had time to spend with our family members. I had nostalgic moments with them. While playing with tamarind chips and shells, I understood the logic of even and odd, and they improved my concentration skills too. Then I started wondering, we go for the yoga classes, see the meditation exercises to scale up these skills, but see how toys help them. Most of the games, children need to play in groups. So they cultivate a habit of sharing, compromising, winning, losing, teaching each other, and whatnot. All kinds of soft skills, which day-to-day life of any industry need, they're taught by themselves. This is the impact of toys in our life. Then I started wondering, we go for the personality development classes, pay them fees to scale up these skills, but see how toys help them. Our ancestors are just incredible. They have created toys right from a child from 3 months old. I know most of you would have noticed a merry go round tied to a cradle of a 3 months old baby, right? When I was wondering why do they do that, my grandma said, for a 3-month-old baby, they won't have their eyes stable. So to improve their eye stability, we let them see the merry-go-round. And we also ring the rattles, right? We can find whether the children can find the direction of sound. Indirectly, we can come to know whether the child is healthy or not. Nowadays, I have seen most of the parents getting toys to know the brain development of a child. My mom gave me her wooden stocking doll when I was 2. Like, we have to identify the smallest one, put it inside the next size, close it, and repeat the process till everything comes in a single toy. Playing with the wooden stocking doll would improve the motor skills as well as mental ability skills in the child. In contrast to the wooden stocking doll, we now have rings and shaped sorter made out of plastic. I have seen my cousin who does it in a wink of an eye. When I was asking my video of doing that, I saw instead of putting rings in the pole, I was just happily throwing in there and was playing a catch and catch game. Toys can be used as anything and they will surely help us to open up our brain. For toddlers, it's not quite easy for them to sort out things. Unless or until they find what is smallest and what is the biggest. Playing with the stacking dolls would improve the mental ability as well as motor skills of the child. My most preferred toy when I was in the age group 1 and 2 was the pull and push ones. I had a dog tied to a rope and my uncle had a duck tied to a rope. When I was wondering, why do we have only duck and dog? I guessed my answer. It will be easy for the child to imitate the sound of a duck, quack, quack, a dog, bow, bow, right? Playing with the pulling toys would surely improve the motor skills of the child. In contrast to those pulling toys, we now have new mechanism of pull and push toy, where if we pull and leave the toy, it will go on its own. Playing with the pulling toys would surely improve the motor skills of the child. Toy world begins from cradle and have endless journey in helping our creativity burst in us. Of course, squeezing toy with sound is planned by 1-year-old boy to enjoy, whereas the same kind of toy is planned by a 40-year-old man to relax. As we grow up, certainly we'll not be playing with merry-go-rounds and rattles. We would select toys which would have technical features for us to play with. When I was a toddler, I preferred toys which were colorful and attractive. When I grew up to the age group of 1 and 2, I was puzzled with push and pull toys. Then I changed my choice of toys to vehicle models, track sets, jigsaw puzzles, and I elevated my choice of toys to innovative, educational, and remote control toys. When I was studying play school, every day when I returned from my school, my grandpa would arrange all of my toys in a room. I basically love to handle traffic. So he will arrange all of them in a neat straight line, which I would love to play with. I would immediately start playing with it, even without eating for hours together. Then slowly, when I started to watch cartoons and understood the names, my choice of toys changed. I started to collect Thomas and his friend's track set. I have 2 big track sets with almost all of the engines in it. Playing with the track sets helped me in learning how to set tracks, how an engine functions, how a real railway line functions. They influenced me to learn all the station names when I go by train. I used to have a hoarding with station names in my setup and would perform a mock driver's kit with my dad and my sister. You know, I lost my sister to sell snacks, accessories and all the other things with the sell in the Indian trains to give the real station feeling. Knowingly or unknowingly, by play-by method, I learned all the station names. Guess what? My sister learnt all the snacks which she need to sell. This is the impact of toys in our life. In contrast to the toy track sets, our parents form train by themselves by holding each other's shoulders. They will be fighting for the driver's position. By this method, it would have improved the teamwork attitude as well as those who are compromised. It would have improved their compromising skills too. If I want to learn anything, be it be geography, a marketplace or a shopping center, I create a mock setup for that and start playing with it. After all, we can create the setup with whatever toys we have. Later, there was craze about puzzles, mainly the jigsaw ones. Once, my friend presented me a puzzle on a birthday. Initially, I thought it will be tough. So I told my mom, "Mom, just keep them safe. Let us give to someone else." One fine day, when I was searching for something interesting, I was tempted to pick it. Solving it was a piece of cake. Playing with the puzzles helped me improve my logical thinking skills. I learned shapes and they improved my symmetry skills too. Can anyone guess how to learn tables using jigsaw puzzles? Well, there's nothing to wonder. We could just take the back side of the puzzles, write the numbers over and below, just not factors and multiples. This is how you could learn tables using jigsaw puzzles. Similarly, we can have it for science formula, maths formula, and all the other things which a child finds difficult to remember. Playing with the puzzles would improve the mathematics skills in the child. As children would improve their mathematics skills, the way they approach the problem is totally different if they are taught with toys. Later, there was craze about the remote control ones. I remember a scenario where my remote control toys helped me, where my dad was having difficulty in parking his car in a narrow lane. I guided him and he was astonished to see how I was able to guide him. After he parked, he came towards me and said, "Wow, you just took the bull by the horn and you have succeeded in it, son. My joy knew no bounds." This is the impact of toys in our life. Playing with the remote control toys would improve the driving skills in the child. Based on the choice of toys of a child, we could read the psychology of the child. Toys are such a wonder. Anything gets into your brain without any stress. Though I have variety of choices in the toy shop, I always go for the toys under the automobile section since I'm autophile. Knowingly or unknowingly, by playway method, I learnt all the car names. This is how my mom identified my skills of learning from toys. Toys are our first teachers, which I strongly believe. The way we use them is what does matter. When my sister was 1 and a half, she could hardly utter a word, but she solved an animal puzzle in wink of an eye. Later, when she grew up, she started loving animals and birds. Toys help us to relish, recreate, and rejoice. When I go for my doctor visit, my doctor used to recommend my parents to give me as many toys so that the entire potential is used to the fullest. It will cultivate patience, reduce anger and anxiety. You should be providing the child with right toy for right age. There may be a bad impact in the psychology of the child if they are not provided with right toy for right age. Most of the parents over here, you would have definitely dusted your children, either as a doctor, teacher, policeman, or any other social workers, right? If you dressed them like a doctor, you would have definitely got them a doctor's set. Children love playing with the stethoscope. This has a deep impact in their brain to frame their ambition. My passion towards toys has not reduced even a bit. I have cultivated the habit of closely following what is the technical improvement in tending toys. As my inquisitiveness grew in vehicles, my ambition slowly peeped into my brain when I was 8. When I was asked by Olympiad Training Institute, instantly I told them, I want to be an automobile architect. This is the impact of toys in our life. I would really promote return and play toys, which are really very useful for both parents as well as children like us to cultivate the habit of knowing things and defining our ambition at early stage. This may bring many shades of personality in the child, and if parents identify them, children would love the work they do for the lifetime. Most of you would have seen this Mr. Bean cartoon, right? He is just very funny. But when he is hurt or when he has to take instant decision, he would be sharing to his daddy. In silence, it will console him. Toys are the bestest busters. I have seen my cousin who has a doll with her. She does all the things like feed her when she eats, make it sleep before she sleeps, and reads book for it. When they grow up, they'll be having a nature of taking care of their friends and family members. But yes, we should not let them speak too much with their dolls. If we are having a conversation with them, they may think us as daddies and we won't have a chance to speak to them. Toy world is just very deep. Can anyone guess what skills to be developed to get toys? After getting influenced by the features of toys, we become the marketing agent for that. We will list down all the features which are only the advantages and would convince our parents to get them. I have done this many times and I would just feel I have just moved a mountain. But when our parents identify our feeling towards toys, we should also yield to their position when they say no to our desires. This will in turn improve our give and take attitude, cultivate the importance of money in us, in turn improving our adjustment skills too. Nowadays, I have seen many families as nuclear families with single child. There are advantages and disadvantages of being a single child. If we are with a sibling, we'll end up in variety of fight for a single toy. And there will be no gender-specific feeling in the choice of toys. But this is not possible if it's a single child. For parents who are getting toys for the single child, please make sure that you ask the opinion of the child before getting the toy. After all, there is nothing wrong in getting soft doll for a boy. The way he could imagine as his brother or sister would fill the vacuum minimum if he really needs a sibling. And for girls, I would suggest them to get remote control toys so that they would improve their driving skills, in turn improving their road safety too. Like how coin has two sides, there are disadvantages of toys too. The main disadvantage is the material we use to make them, plastics. We have a trend where we bring the old fashioned as the new trend. We could very well go for older materials like clay, wood, bamboo, terracotta, even paper mesh materials to make toys. Toys have become part and parcel of child's life nowadays, but not everybody could afford them. This was the case few years back for books. As many of the donors came together, we now had lots and lots of libraries filled with lots of books. I thought, how will it be if we have a toy library too? What does that mean? We can donate our unused toys. Children coming there would dive into the toy world and scale up their skills. There can also be alternative where a toy donation box can be installed in every school. Students who don't use the toys can donate them there. They can be awarded with donation certificate, and children in rural area can also get what we all get, right? Actions speak more than words. It's a famous quote, which I think is the most apt quote for the toy provided to a child. If we work on different ideas, we'll end up in different inventions. As so Thomas Alva Edison has made 400 different inventions. Change is the only thing that does not change at all. I have seen in a mobile repair shop, they would take the working part from the damaged mobile, replace it in a working phone, and make them work. I thought, how will it be if we recreate the toys too? What does that mean? Children can bring their old broken toys to school, work on them, recreate them, and the best toy recreator would be given recognition. This will surely improve the confidence in any field the child is going to take care. Now, friends and parents, you are going to agree with my mentor, toys, right? Let me conclude my talk with my own quote. Toy is a joy you need to enjoy. It's a treasure hunt to scale up our skills. Be confident to climb up the hill. This is Vishnu S. Raghavan signing off. Thank you.